In this video, we're going to learn 5 audio tricks that are going to make your videos sound so much better. Now, the first tip or trick that I want to share with you is Adobe Enhance. Now, you may not have heard of this before because it is pretty new, it's still in beta, but it is so good already that I really want you to try this out as it makes every microphone sound expensive. This is what the audio sounds like straight out of the camera. That is going to be our sample clip, so let's go ahead and use Enhance. Let's go to podcast.adobe.com/enhance. Upload your file right here and simply let Adobe do its magic. Now, depending on the size of the file that you're uploading, this could take a few minutes. But once it's done, let's download it and see what it sounds like now. This is what the audio sounds like straight out of the camera.
And this is what it sounds like after using Adobe Enhance.
Like I said before, it is still in beta, so I'm really hoping that when it comes out of beta, when it's fully ready, that we're going to see some controls so we can increase or decrease the enhancement, for example, as I do think sometimes it sounds a little bit too flat and it takes away all of the environment vibes that you do need in your video. But I do really think that this is a game changer for a lot of us. When you're putting together your video and you're editing audio, you're probably going to be hearing some glitches and some pops in between the cuts from time to time. Now, the easiest way to get rid of this is either create a keyframe and another keyframe and just drag it all the way down to remove that pop, or just add a quick fade at the beginning or at the end of the clip by hitting Control Shift D or Command Shift D and shorten the fade. What we're looking at right now is a timeline where I cut together some talking bits, also known as A-roll, and we have a few B-roll sections in here. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open up the Essential Sounds panel. Go to Window and click on Essential Sound. Now select all of the audio and label it as Dialogue. Then we're gonna go to Loudness and Auto Match. Now, if you're filming in a studio like mine, you probably don't need to do this, but you could still do this if you want to, but this is especially beneficial if you're shooting in different places and the audio levels just aren't entirely the same. This is a very easy way to just level all of the audio in your video. In the Essential Sound panel, there are a ton of features that you can use to edit your audio, and I actually made a video about this a few years ago. If you want to check that out, link will be somewhere, but please, please don't judge me because we have come a very long way. Now, this wasn't actually the second tip, because the second tip is, in my opinion, still quite underused, and that is audio ducking. In the Essential Sound panel, you will find a feature to automatically duck the music, which means that you can automatically lower the music when you're speaking, for example, and up the music when you're not. But for that, we're going to need music first. Now, you can get your music from anywhere, but if you want to publish it online, there's two things that you want to take into account. And one, if you're doing a talking head video like this, use songs without vocals, because otherwise it's going to be very distracting. But more importantly, if you want to upload it online, make sure that it's copyright free or that you have the rights to use the music.
This is a load of barnacles.
For this video, I'm going to use a website called Track Club. This is a music provider that offers high quality music made by real artists. So let's go to trackclub.com if you want. There will be a link in the description for a free trial. Now, on Track Club, we can go to playlists, for example, and then pick one of those playlists. Or as you can see, you can also filter it by genre, mood, or theme. I personally filter by mood because I find that feeling is very important when it comes to finding the right music for your video. Whether it's a storytelling video or whether it's a talking head video like this. In this case, for this specific video, we're gonna go and click on chill. Loch Ness actually sounds really good, but I do wanna make a few changes. So I'm gonna click on this button right here called MixLab, and this is what separates Track Club from all the other music libraries. MixLab allows you to customize any song. So here we have all of the stems or the musical instruments used to compose this song. As you can see, there's controls that we can use to adjust it to our liking. So with some music libraries, online, you can get a drum stem, but on Track Club, you get the hi-hats, percussion, and drums. So this allows for so much more creative control, because now we can customize a song and really make it fit our video and the vibe of our video. We can solo a track if we just want to hear that track, we can mute the track if we don't want that to be in our song, and we can change the volume of each single instrument. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be taking out the rain effect, so I'm going to mute that. And then as you can see up here, you can also change the BPM to make a song fit the energy of your video better. Honestly, for me, for this video, I think that the original sounds fine, so let's download it. Again, if this sounds good to you, there will be a link in the description to check out Track Club completely for free, so go check it out. All right, we've downloaded the song, so let's pop it on the timeline, select it, and in the Essential Sound panel, we're going to label this as music. Now we can finally use the audio ducking feature. In the Essential Sound panel, let's check the box to enable the ducking. We're gonna choose Duck Against Dialogue. dialogue because we want the music to follow the dialogue. And then we're just going to adjust the duck amount and the fade duration a little bit. Click on generate keyframes. Honestly, these settings are pretty random, so I would really recommend you just play around with the settings until you're happy with the way that it sounds. By the way, if you're enjoying this video so far, obviously subscribe, but more importantly, I would actually like to know if you have an audio trick that you want to share with us. If so, please put it in the comments so we can all learn from each other. Now, the next tip is about a feature that still a lot of people don't know about, and it blows my mind because I use it for every single video and I've talked about it in a few of my videos, and I'm gonna mention it again. Now, if you want to use the same song, in this case our track club song, throughout the entire video, we could go listen to the beat, cut on the beat, copy that and paste it, add a fade, or we can use the remix tool. Now, there's two ways to use this tool. We can either right click on the song, then click on remix and then enable remix, or, which is my preferred method, we can go to the toolbar, click and hold the ripple edit tool, and then click on the remix tool. Then we have to extend our track club song all the way till the end of the video. I personally love this way more than right clicking and then enabling the remix tool, because I have no idea what the duration of this video is, except for if I would look on the timeline and see where the final frame is. It's too much work. If you can just extend it by dragging it out, that works best for me, but obviously do what is best for you. I've been using this in most of my videos on YouTube. I think it sounds great, and you cannot only extend a song if you want to, but also shorten a song. So if you have a 30 or a 60 second reel, for example, and you still want that build up, you still basically want the same structure of that song, you can use the remix tool and it will do it for you. But one thing that is important to mention, if you are using the audio ducking feature, make sure that you regenerate the keyframes. Then we have another tip that is very helpful whether you're editing audio or you're editing music. On the default timeline on Premiere Pro, we can edit per frame. However, sometimes those frames just don't align with the beat of the music, so it feels a little bit off, or maybe you just want to more precisely edit the audio. Now, in that case, what we can do is we can click on the hamburger menu next to the name of the sequence and then click on Show Audio Time units. Now, as you can see, you can move the music around more freely, or you can cut the audio more precisely, because audio is not shot in frames or like recorded in frames, whereas video is. Now, the following tip is all about AI, because AI makes the world better, does it? I don't know. But AI can make your videos a lot better. What AI, you might be wondering, besides Adobe Enhance? Well, I made a video about it, so I highly recommend you to check it out right here. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this video. And if you want some free music, go check out the free trial from Track Club, link in the description.